really have sheets, science, health and education. Anything we do in health has to be proven. All the descriptive things are very difficult to get into governments and say, this is what has been proven, this is economically feasible. There's a lot of skepticism. There's a lot of work has to be done on the research arena. Second, we talk a lot about disease. Should we talk more about health? Second issue. And third, are we really paying attention to education? All of us need to be educated in a world that is moving so rapidly with so much heterogeneity. Well, we have six projects in the world. I'm going to talk about one. If you want in the discussion, we'll talk about the others. And the projects are divided in age. Children, adults, and this is the elderly, which are absolutely focused, or all scientific, are all randomized, and all have a purpose. I just want to focus finally on the one we started with children. The IOM, one of the chapters is, we should do something in early childhood. Science magazine, very recently, this is in the cover. Are we paying attention to the tremendous impact and the window of opportunity in children that we have? We develop a group, actually, Joe Buford is here. I wanted to do this in the United States, I couldn't. And she said, look, go to Latin American countries, there is passion there and good organization. And I ended up in Colombia, Bogota. I work with Sesame Street, I'm the medical advisor. So I said, let's pull it together. And we ended up in Bogota, and it is a group of people, just pay attention to this name, Beatriz Londoño. We randomize 6,000 children. And the randomization is between age 3 to 5. Why? Because the hypothesis is that most of our behavior as adults comes from the environment that we live between age 3 to 5. And if cardiovascular disease is something of behavior, can we infuse health as a priority in these children? What I couldn't do in the United States, I was able to do it in Bogota. 40 hours of health within a period of 6 months in a group and 4 hours in the other. It's a randomized study. What did we teach? How your body works, the issue of nutrition, and the issue of physical activity. We didn't do anything on emotions in Colombia. The results are outstanding. Our research is going to be published soon in the Green Journal, American Journal of Medicine. This is the group that during 40 hours, we did the three. We teach them the three aspects I mentioned, how your body works, the issue of nutrition, and exercise. And what we do is we had 40 questions at the end, which had to do with knowledge. Do you understand what we are talking about? Second, would you change? We call this attitude. And third, did you already change? This is habit. This is children between age 3 to 5, 6,000 children. The results were outstanding, I can tell you. The three aspects, attitude, habit, and understanding or knowledge were extremely high on these kids. But we also told the parents and the teachers. Then we said, what happened if we do not intervene for a year? Even better, because now the whole community is into health. Let me summarize, as we have in the discussion of the paper. We found that the children have a higher impact on the behavior of the parents than the parents on the behavior of the children. In other words, these children are able to make the parents to stop smoking, are able to make the parents to eat as a family, something that is lost, are able to make the parents to exercise, and are able to go to the school system and make that the teachers change completely their soft drinks. That's what we found. Now we have an ethical problem. What do we do with the control group, which we really achieve nothing? So a year later, we did the same. And even better than the first group, also the first finding is the ideal age between 4 to 6, not between 3 and 5. We delay everything 1 year. This is going to be like Framingham. It's a 20-year study. We see when we have to intervene to look at whether we have an impact on the behavior of these children. At this moment, it's absolutely outstanding. And the results, this is all randomized. Well, this obviously had impact. This is the wife of the president of Colombia. We got all together, this is Sesame, we are now working with 25,000 children. And we started with 6,000, 25,000. Funding, no problem. At the moment we have data, to present to the government. Then the government in Spain, there are two governments, as you know, you call the right or the left, call it anyone, they both called me. And they said, in view of that, can you do this in Spain? This is what we did in Spain, but let me talk about the lady I mentioned before, yeah. Lordoño, Beatriz. She and I started the project with Sesame. She's now the Minister of Health in Colombia. And the reason is all the success of the study. So you can have a tremendous impact if you have the right hypothesis and you put science into it. And then you move on. This is Spain. And we began the project in Spain. And here we have science. This is the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute in Spain. I am the director. I go there every week. This is Ferran Adrià. This is the number one, actually, chef in the world for 3 consecutive years. He and I have a foundation called Alicia. And this is actually Sesame. You have science, health, and education. That's what it is. And we are all working together. In Spain, we have added 2 things. One is control your emotions. Why? We believe that these children, when they reach age 10 to 15, they are exposed to drugs. Can we teach them to say no at age 4 to 6? Can we teach them to control their emotions? Great success at this moment on that project. The parents are delighted. They don't care so much about nutrition. They care about what we tell them about this aspect. And actually, the Institute of Medicine, one of the chapters is, we have to go now in children between age 8, 9, 10 to 15. And we begin with these emotion aspects between age 4 to 6. But this is very interesting. Some of you may know the Barcelona Soccer Club. It's considered the number one in the world. They called me a year ago. And they said, do you know that your hypothesis of pulling people together at young age is exactly how our players are? They are all in a farm. Messi and all these people started at age 11 in a farm. They are 85. And are between age 9 and age 17. 2 already play in the first team. And they said, what do you want me to do? He says, well, we start with the same concept. You start in childhood. Here we start early. From these people, only 10 will make it in the first team. Can you teach them Plan B? And I said, what can I teach about Plan B? This all came together when the Spanish government told us we should move from age 4 to 6, moving on later. We are following all these kids, but can we start somebody at age 9? And this is the message I want to give to you. I am completely convinced that the young people are the future. The thing is, we are not untapping them. Let me give you why. We started a program with young people between age 9 and age 16 on 6 positive things, positivity. One is mental health, 40s. Time to reflect every day to set up your priorities. We are doing this with the soccer team. Second, what is your talent? Not only soccer. Find it is something else in case soccer doesn't work. Third, transmit positivity. Stop criticizing. And fourth, tutorial. Listen to people who you trust, who will tell you what to do. 40s. But here comes the issue. How this is transmitted to society and the society impacts of you. These are the 4 A's. This is very much oriental influence, but that's where we start. Attitude. If this ceiling falls apart, we should not spend time talking about the institution of the Institute of Science or the architects who built it. How do we solve it? Attitude. This is Lama's philosophy. Accept. Accept who I am. Resentment is one of the dangers of our society today. Don't look at your neighbor, what he has. Just work with what you have. And this is critically important, accept. This is actually Paul Schweitzer. The there, according. According means, if I am here today and I go home tonight, I should be the same person. That's not so simple. Consistency. And the final thing we found most important is altruism. And that is, in my experience, the people who give are the happiest people in the world. Because it creates self-esteem and makes you more. This is a program that we have developed in young people, which is completely different than the program of health that I mentioned between age 4 to 6. It's all randomized. So we are going to see how it works. But I can tell you, at this moment, it's a real success. And I stop here. I certainly have 5 other programs, but I'd like to present 2 last slides because I think are important. Young people. This is the NHLBI in Spain. And you say, who they are? we pick up the scientists of the future at age 16 in the whole school system in Spain. We give them the opportunity with a grant to work in a laboratory or to work, some are actually working in a project with us in Kenya. They get excited about it, they all want to be investigators, whether it's in social work, whether it's in basic science. And then they come back, and here we have the people of the future. We are going to have 300 people in Spain discover at age 16 they will be the investigators in the future in 5 years from now. And here you say, who are those? This is the program She, Science, Health and Education in the town of my wife, 3,000 people. These are all the kids between age 3 and 6 here, which are now part of the program I mentioned to you. Doesn't matter how you get into the young people, whether it will be the investigators of the future, or you talk about health, better we stop talking too much and pay attention to them, because the potential I have seen is incredible. And the final comment is funding. We have 6 projects in the world, are all funded. How I got the funding, don't ask me, but it happens. Because at the moment you have a hypothesis and people see you're trying to do something for society, not for you, the money comes. These are probably the most successful people in Spain in terms of industry. There's no pharmaceutical companies. They are funding the projects in science and the educational programs I mentioned to you in the National Heart, Lung and Blood Institute. And these are the people who are actually funding the projects that we have going to the public, which is what I presented to you today. This is probably, you know, Javier Solana, who was, worked with the European group and with the government. So I just like to finish by saying to you that, frankly, we have to pay attention to the kids. Another thing we talked about, if we talk generically about, for example, in the 3 different ages, to me, health is completely different. If you talk to a child, if you talk to an adult, or if you talk to elderly people. That's why our projects, by the way, are all scientifically based with hypotheses, have this particular principle. These are 3 different ages, but the one I really would like to, at least I presented to you today, is the one at young age. Thank you very much.